Stay tuned, because as requested, we're going to go through the install and overview of Powertoys for Windows 10. Hi guys, welcome back. In this video, we're going to look at Microsoft Powertoys, which has finally made a return for Windows 10. First of all, if you're new here, it's great to have you along. Please think about subscribing for more tutorials, tips, reviews to make your tech life easier. If you're a returning viewer, welcome back. Let's get straight into it. So back in my Windows 10 video, my bonus tip for that video was Powertoys. And I put it out there. If you want to see a more in-depth video on Powertoys, then let me know and you let me know. So here it is. What is Powertoys? Well, it's a set of freeware system utilities built for power users that's developed by Microsoft. These allow you to add or change features to maximize productivity or just add some more customization. What's the history? Well, it was first built for Windows 95, where it was quite popular. It then moved over to Windows XP, but we've not seen it since. They've now released it back in April 19, I believe, for Windows 10, and since then it's been being updated. I think we're on release 19 now, but there will be links in the description when we go to install it. So we're going to go straight into it, and we're going to go into the install. Now, what's strange about Powertoys is it doesn't come part of Windows download, and you cannot get it in the Windows Store. Strangely, you have to go to GitHub to download Powertoys, which makes more sense now, as since June 2018, Microsoft own GitHub. Let's download it and let's get into it.
Okay, the first thing we need to do is to download it. All you need to do is go to this website here, which is GitHub. Obviously, this will take you to the latest release. So no matter when you're watching this video, if you go to this site, hopefully it'll be the same, and the latest release will be the first one. We're currently on 19.2. If you just click on the first one, it'll take you to the download page, and just down there, click on the download, let it download, find the installer and install. Once it's downloaded, then you should find it in your quick links in your system tray, just there, and open it, and there we have Powertoys downloaded, ready to go.
So now it's downloaded and installed, we're going to start taking a look at each section individually. Now, to make it easy for you, I'm going to do this in order as it's listed within the Powertoys window on the left hand side. This video is timestamped, so you can skip to the chapter you require. Let's go straight into it with the General tab.
Okay, so as I mentioned, we're going to go through these in order. First is the General tab. This is just your settings. When you first start it, this will be illuminated because it won't be opened up in administrator. Some of these you need to be administrator to run. I already start in administrator and then just turn that on, so it always starts up in administrator. Tile up to you, there you go. You can learn more about administrator mode right there. Appearance, there's two, there's dark or light or a system default. My system default is on dark, so that's why it's on dark. And you can choose to run it at startup, should you wish. I believe this is one of the new updates that's come in. You can check for updates, and what it will do, it will check for updates and come down there and tell you it's up to date. It used to be a case of, if you check for updates, it would take you to the GitHub website and show you the latest version. And then you can turn automatic download of updates on. Again, I think that's a new version. You have to go yourself to GitHub and download the updates. And there you go. And of course, you've got your terms and conditions. There's your General tab, pretty simple, there you go.
So now your settings are right and you've got it set up just exactly how you want it. We're going to now have a look at FancyZones. Now, Windows already has the facility to snap multiple windows into different zones on the screen. Well, with FancyZones, which is probably one of the most popular uses for Powertoys, it lets you customize it and it lets you have up to 40 window snaps. Whoever uses that, I don't know, but let's take a closer look.
Okay, so let's talk about FancyZones. Not the name I would have given it, but hey, I don't get paid for this. So FancyZones, then, it's the next one down. The first thing you need to do if you're going to use it is enable it. So turn it on, and that's how you do it. So that's how you launch the Zones editor. You can open it by using window and apostrophe key. That's the shortcut, so you don't have to launch FancyZones. but the zones editor, this is what we're talking about. Now the default settings are these five here, and they are set for four windows. I don't know why I do that, that's same as what's in Windows, but there we go. Now you can have, if you really wanted to, 40 windows. 40 windows, I mean, you won't be able to see anything in there. But the option's there if you need it. Okay, let's take this back down to four. And what we'll do is, so this is the default. What you can do is you can go to custom, create new custom, edit selected layout, and then you add a new zone. Now this is one zone, so we're going to talk about four windows. In fact, we'll do five. And you can move these along and resize them however you need until you get five. And there you are. So that's just five. So very quickly, custom, you'd save and apply, give it a name. Now every time you use Fancy Zones, these are where they'd snap to. I'm going to cancel that now and just show you how Fancy Zones work. So what have we got selected? So we've got priority grid selected. We'll apply that. Now, to work Fancy Zones, in fact, we'll take this window as a number one. All you need to do is hold shift. That would activate Fancy Zones. And you can see behind, you get the windows where it's going to snap to. Now, where it's blue, that's where it would snap to. So once it turns blue, you just let go of the mouse button and it snaps. Then once you get another window, press shift and there you go. And that's what it's all about. Let's snap that to there. Looking in, Fancy Zones then. I told you about the shortcut key. There are some different options you can tick on there. Have a play about with them. I won't go over them. The appearance, zone, highlight, opacity. That's just how transparent the Fancy Zones are once you've pressed shift. Leave it at 44%. Zone highlight color, as you've seen, once the window hovers over it, it currently turns blue. This is the outline color. Let's turn this red and I'll just show you what it looks like. So if we do that now, hold shift, you'll see the Fancy Zones now have a red line around them. Again, it's up to you. You can play about with these however you want. You can exclude an app from the Fancy Zones, so they only react to the window snap. You just have to type it in there. And yeah, there's Fancy Zones.
File Explorer Preview. Now this is only really used if you use SVG files or Markdown files. I don't, but let's have a look at it anyway, just in case you do.
So moving on then, we're going to have a quick look at File Explorer Preview. Again, if you didn't know, within File Explorer, you can turn on a preview pane. So when you select a file, it shows a preview on the right-hand side. There's two ways you can do that. If you go to View, Preview Pane, or you can simply press Alt-P to turn it on and off, just like that. Okay, so that's default. That's just normal in Windows. However, if you have .svg files or .md files, this will also allow you to preview them within the File Explorer. Just turn it on.
Next on the list is Image Resizer, which does exactly what it says on the tin. This integrates with File Explorer and allows you, by right-clicking, opening up the context menu, to select one or more images to resize to a custom size that you can set in Powertoys themselves. Let's take a look how to do this.
Okay, Image Resizer. Again, does exactly what it says on the tin. This allows you to bulk edit images and resize them. So in here, this is where you have your defaults and you can make the changes. Now there's four defaults for small, medium, large, and phone. If you want to change one and add a custom size, you just tick add a size and change the parameters. In the fit, you get the option for fill, fit, or stretch. And the sizing can either be done in centimeters, inches, percent, or pixels. There's your encoding options, PNG, bitmap, that sort of stuff, however you want to use it. and then the file naming, how you want to do it. How do you do it? Again, it's pretty simple. So here are my images for this video that I'm creating. We've got 10 PNGs there, but you can imagine if you've got 300 photos that you need to all resize. This is how you do it. You just select them all, you'd right click and you'd click on resize pictures. The image resizer would open. There you have your four default Powertoys settings and the custom one which you'd set yourself, and a couple of other options if you want to use them or not. Once you've done that, you'd click on resize and they'd all resize. Very clever, and I know loads of people who use this daily. It's a well thought out tool and well used.
Next up, we've got Keyboard Manager. This allows you to remap keys or shortcuts for your convenience, however you want to do it. Let's take a look at this.
So Keyboard Manager then, yeah, it's a very simple tool. It does what it says on the tin. There's two things you can do in this. There's remap single keys or remap shortcuts. Again, you have to enable it in Powertoys if you want to use it. Remap key. Choose the key you want to hit to the key you want it to show once you hit it. Simple as that. Remap shortcut, if for any reason, I don't know, you want to change Control C from paste to open up File Explorer, then you'd change it. You type the shortcut, what it currently is, and map it to. It's very simple. If you want to use that, I can see people using it. I don't myself. I'm happy with my shortcuts, but it's a tool there to be used.
Another simple but very useful feature next, and that's Power Rename. This allows you to bulk rename files without individually going in and try to rename every single file one at a time. Really handy, let's take a look.
Power Rename then, very handy tool if you need to rename files in bulk. Again, you need to enable it in there. There are some options on there. Change your maximum number of items. I think it's defaulted to 10, but even if you've only got 5 or 6, it'll still save you time. So yeah, change that. How do you do it? Again, it's really simple. Let's say you've got a load of files that you want to rename. You'd select them all, open up the context menu and go down to Power Rename. Once you're in there, it's just a case of searching for text to replace. So if we're going to search for Powertoys, and what it does in the bottom here, it gives you a preview. So these are the original ones as it is, and then you're going to replace it with, let's say, TD underscore tech. So you get a preview. So this is what they were called, this is what they're going to be called now, and you click on rename and they all get renamed at the same time. Very handy tool.
Next, we've got Powertoys Run, which is just a little simple feature. All it is just another way to search for settings and folders. It has the same functionality as a search bar that you'll find on the taskbar, but it's in Powertoys. Let's have a quick look at this.
Powertoys Run then, again, another real simple tool. There's minimal options you can do with it. Again, you need to enable it. Maximum number of results, yeah, you can change that. There's the shortcut that you need, Alt and Space, and that's pretty much it. I forgot to mention earlier, but in all these options on the right hand side, there is a module overview which will take you to GitHub and give you a full rundown of how to use these things. But Powertoys Run, yeah, that's what it is. All you need to do is hit Alt and Space, and this is what you get. And then you just type what you need. Let's go for Control Panel. And this is what it is. It's just the same functionality of the search bar at the bottom. It's just easier to read, and if you've got loads of things open, then it might be quicker for you if you want to use it that way.
And finally, a real simple feature, but quite handy to be honest, it's a shortcut guide. We all know Windows has loads of keyboard shortcuts, and sometimes it's hard to keep a track of these. This is a simple little feature that you can turn on for a little cheat sheet right on your screen. Let's have a look.
Okay, shortcut guide. Real simple. Again, enable it. These are the options you've got. The shortcut for this is just to press and hold the Windows key, and this is where you can change how long that window key needs opening for before it opens. The opacity of the background is so you can see what's going on the desktop when the shortcut guide is open. So how transparent do you want it to be? And obviously you've got your theme. Let's see it in action. Press and hold the Windows key and this is what pops up. Now just bearing in mind, this is just the Windows shortcut key. So these are all the things you need to press while holding the Windows key and what will happen to it. Real simple.
There we have it. There's Powertoys Windows 2010 for you. Now it is made for power users, but I'm pretty sure everyday users could at least find some functionality on some of those features in Powertoys. If you've got an idea for a video you'd like to see, if you want me to go more in depth on anything on Windows 10 or any other tutorial, please let me know in the comments. If you like that, please give me a like, it really does help. If you haven't subscribed yet, then that's up here, and I'll put some more videos up here that I think you might find interesting. Guys, for now, I'll see you next week.